Okay, hello. We are today with a new wine, with a new red wine from Rioja, D-O-C-A. Someone is with me, someone from the winery, but I think it's really important for me and for you to listen to the history of this winery, and the most important thing is where it is situated. So tell us, please, where is Hacienda El Ternero?
Yes, it's a very strange place. This was an old monastery up in the mountains, and we belong to Castile, which is very strange, because, you know, we are the only winery belonging to Castile, but we are in the Dio Rioja. We are physically, we are part of Rioja, but there's a mountain between Castile and us. So the name Ternero, which is a young cow, a calf, is from the back in the 11th century, when the monks situated a monastery there, all surrounded by vineyards at that time already, and they were quiet in the mountain producing wine, so very, very happy. Wow. Life.
Really different. I mean, imagine that you are from London, you live in London, and in the middle of London you have a place, small place, belonging to Scotland.
Yes,
for example.
Something like this.
It's more or less the same thing. So, and tell me, what about this wine, Hacienda El Ternero? Because it's a wine age in barrel,
yes,
but with this greenback label of typical of the young wines of Rioja. So tell us why you have chosen this.
Yes, okay, this is a wine that has been fermented 16 months in French oak. This is very important for us because French oak, we think, is less aggressive to the wine, so we want to preserve the fruit, the terroir. It's very important for us. We want fruity wines, not oaky wines. So we don't want to be labeled as a crianza because this wine is a little above a crianza. It's 16 okay. months, a very good French oak.
And it's important that you're situated beside the mountains.
Yes.
So you are the last of the harvest in Rioja.
Yes, it's true. The last harvest in Rioja. Last year we finished around the 4th of November.
Wow.
Yes, it's very late, sometimes even with snow.
Yeah, really?
Yes. Sometimes we finish the harvest with snow. Yes.
You have to make ice wine next time.
Actually, we have a small piece of Riesling.
Really?
Yes.
So perhaps next ice wine is coming from Hacienda El Ternero. Yeah. We're going to taste it. So really important, the fruit, as John is telling us. I think it's really important to find this, not the oak, only the oak, like in the typical and classics wines from crianzas from Rioja. You have fruit. Of course, the hints of the oak are here, but the fruits are really important. So, and then we taste it. And something that I like in this wine, I have tasted it before, is the fruit that you have smelled, you have in your mouth too, but you have freshness, incredible.
Yes, acidity always comes from the altitude. We are at 650 meters in altitude, very strange in Rioja too. So good acidity is very natural at this altitude, and low production, which means high quality.
Quantity of bottles in a year, more or less?
Around 25,000.
So you have to be in a hurry to buy these bottles because there's a low production. Thank you, John, for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.